Good afternoon, folks. I hope you and your friends and family are having as good of a time as you can considering the current global pandemic. But it is that whole COVID-19 situation that is actually the cause for today's video, because we're going to talk about Roll20 modules and game add-ons. And the reason I bring that up is there's a promotion in Roll20 right now called Stay at Home, Stay Safe. Because, of course, with the social distancing and the stay-at-home orders that most of the world is currently undergoing, many folks are having to transition their games into online games. Instead of playing around a table, they're now seeking out virtual tabletops and other online tools in order to continue their RPG campaigns. So let's jump over into Roll20 and see what it takes to load up a full module and what it means to add a game add-on into your game. So jumping into the Roll20 marketplace, I have already filtered it down to just be the adventure modules and sorted it from low to high because I wanted to show off a couple of things that are free in there right now. We have the Master's Vault, which is Roll20's kind of tutorial, learn Roll20 and also do a quick one-shot adventure. We have the Lost Mine of Phandelver, which is Wizards of the Coast official starter set for D&D 5e, and it's currently free until May 7th. And then we also have down here the Sunless Citadel, which is one of the adventures out of the Yawning Portal, Tales of the Yawning Portal book, and it is also free until May 14th. So the thing that I want to point out, though, is one of these, Lost Mine of Phandelver, is a module, and the other one, the Sunless Citadel, is an add-on, and there's a difference between the two. A module creates a whole new game in your My Games listing. An add-on can be added to any existing game. You can create a blank game and then put the add-on into it, but you must have a game to add it to first. If we were to click on Lost Mine of Phandelver, it'll take us to the product store page on the marketplace, and then we can click the purchase button, and that will take us to the generate a new game page. We'll need to add a title and then verify that the game is using the correct character sheet. Most of the store-bought modules should have this already set up. If you were creating your own game, you would have to set the character sheet to be whatever system you're using. But from there, we can hit OK and generate the game. And then as the game is building, you'll see the big purple adding the module warning across there. It's going to add all those maps, tokens, NPC character sheets, all the handouts and everything will all be added in as soon as we go to launch our game. If we jump back to purchase the Sunless Citadel module, you'll see that the add-on steps are slightly different because there's two ways that you can add an add-on into your Roll20. Purchasing the game will take you to the Start a New Game page, just like with the module, but you'll see that the screen is slightly different. On the left-hand side, the Choose a Character Sheet option has not been filled out by default. And on the right-hand side, it now allows you to choose a module. We could theoretically click on the Essentials Kit module and then add this add-on to it. We could also scroll down and find the Lost Mine of Phandelver, and we'd be generating a new second Lost Mine of Phandelver game, which then would insert this Sunless Citadel add-on into it. The second way, though, is we can go back to our already created Lost Mine game and say this is a campaign that you've had going for some time. Now you need a one-shot. You need you finished the adventure and you want to do something else, and you found the Sunless Citadel add-on and you want to add it in without having to generate a new game and invite all the players to it and move everything over there. You can simply come to the game details page, scroll down to where it says add-ons, and then you'll have a drop-down list of all the add-ons that you have purchased or acquired in your Roll20. On that add-on, I can simply go down to the Sunless Citadel and click Add to Game, and it will start including the add-on. And then we get that purple warning box again saying the add-on Sunless Citadel is being added to the game. And bam, now it's in the game. For both add-ons and modules, you'll see this green box which says it's been successfully been added to the game. And throughout the life of that game, anytime Roll20 adds an update to that module or add-on, anytime they fix text errors or tweak things slightly, you'll get a green notification here saying that there's an update available for your game. It's good practice to keep a backup of your Roll20 games. I normally back mine up about once a month, and I do it before any updates if I'm using one of the the official modules from the marketplace. Now, I've never actually had a problem with anything that required that I go get my backup copy. I'm just one of those paranoid folks that doesn't like losing hours and hours and hours of campaign prep. So before I do anything major in terms of changes or updates, I just make a backup copy to cover my own bases. But yeah, so there's the video for today. We covered modules, we covered add-ons, and remember, modules create a new game. They cannot be added, at least to my knowledge, to an existing game. If you purchase a module, it creates a new game, and then everything, maps, tokens, NPCs, character sheets, will all be loaded in there. An add-on can be purchased from the marketplace, whether it's an adventure itself, a set of tokens, map tiles, whatever, handouts. Add-ons can be added to an existing game, or when you purchase it, it gives you the options to create a new game, but then you'll have a blank game plus whatever that add-on is. If you have any questions about either of those things or something else about Roll20, leave a comment down below and I will do my best to either answer it in the comments or make a video specifically covering that topic. So thanks again for listening and good luck out there. Wash your hands. I do want to thank Roll20 for sponsoring my channel and this video. They have seen fit to include me in their Roll20 Spotlight program, which gives me 1 year of their Roll20 Pro subscription for free. It's super handy in both my tutorials videos and in my actual play games. So thanks, Roll20.